Laboratory Chairs. I'm a medical technologist attached to the Ghana Livestock Development Authority, Veterinary Services Laboratory. And I was invited here to do these various trainings at the NPHR and the Public Health Reference Laboratory in collaboration with WHO, which I found to be very beneficial. We learned about yellow fever, dengue, and the novel coronavirus. I have a passion for molecular biology, and it was really great. I've been training at NPHR for over 6 months under Ms. Shimiza, and she's taught me a lot, and I'm really grateful for that, because the veterinary lab at GLDA is now up and coming, and I've gotten a great deal of knowledge through training under Ms. Shimiza. And thanks to this training, I was able to build on top of that. And I'm very grateful to Dr. Gresh for coming, because things which he clarified a lot of things which I was uncertain about, and which, because I was really looking for someone who spoke in this area. Ms. Shimiza provided a lot of guidance, but there were certain critical areas which you can only do so much, which I'm grateful that Dr. Gresh provided. During this training, we learned to extract. There were different segments to this training. For the yellow fever segment, we learned to extract RNA from tissues stored in formalin, tissues embedded in paraffin, and fresh TBC samples using various methods such as proteinase K, which was used to digest the tissues, and a mechanical method. So we practiced tissue disruption and digestion of tissues using these enzymes, after which we did RNA extraction and tested for yellow fever. For the novel coronavirus, we learned about the different RDRP gene and the E genes, which are used for detection and confirmation of the coronavirus. And during this time of crisis where there is a corona endemic, I believe that knowledge is very useful. Also for the dengue virus, we learned to serotype the four serotypes of dengue to identify them using PCR. So not only can we confirm whether the person has dengue, we can also be able to identify which serotype they have. And even though I work with an animal lab, the yellow fever is a zoonotic disease which can be transmitted from non-human primates to humans. So this training has been very helpful in terms of helping you understand how to be able to test for this virus.